Hello. Alyshia here from Scitech's Toy Teardown, the video series where we take toys you know and love and we pull them apart and we try to use some science to explain how they work. We're here at Scitech on beautiful Wajak Noongar Buja, and today we're going to be pulling apart crystal flyers. So crystal flyers are made by a company called Hatchimals. They came out with these toys a few years ago and they're massively popular because they actually broke their self out of this shell. I'm actually super excited about these crystal flyers because they remind me a lot of a toy called the Sky Dancer, which I absolutely loved as a kid in the 90s. So Sky Dancer dolls were pretty simple. They were just a doll and they plugged into this base. You would pull the string and the base spun the doll around, rotating her wings, and she would launch directly into the air and potentially break something. So Sky Dancers actually ended up getting recalled in the year 2000 because they caused over 100 reported injuries, the likes of broken teeth, scratched eyes. I can totally understand why they were recalled, because I know that my sister and I used Sky Dancers as weapons of destruction. Ah, good memories. But it's not 1994, it's 2022, and I'm super excited to figure out what this magical flying pixie is capable of. Is it similar to Sky Dancers? Is it safer? Is it cooler? I don't know, I'm super excited. I've been taken back to my childhood and I just can't wait to open this up. It's about time I opened it up. It's probably one of the coolest packaging I've ever seen. What does it say? Hatchimals Crystal Flyer. Use your pixie power to guide her. Never heard of pixie power before, but you never know. Let's have a look at this thing. Caution, hair entanglement. Secure any loose clothing for indoor use only. Okay, I'm gonna remove you now. Does it screw off? Oop. Okay, removing Pixie. Oh, cool. She's got a little plastic cape on. We'll free you, poor Pixie. Be free from your worldly attachments. Cool, all right. Okay, she charges. There's a little hole on the side of her skirt. Suppose we're gonna have to wait for this to charge up. All right, so I think she's fully charged now. Get rid of this. Interesting that she actually plugs into power, which might mean that she must have some kind of electronics in her. Let's have a quick look. So she sits on this base. She has these wings which spin around. I think they spin. Okay, so they might actually spin in different ways. And quite interestingly, these pink bits here. Got no idea what they're for, but I reckon it's about time we turned you on and had a bit of a play. So I think what she's supposed to do is when we turn her on, she flies up into the air and you can apparently, according to the instructions, you can guide her with your pixie powers. Interesting to see what those are. Are you ready? First flight. Okay. Ah! All right, cool. Gonna let her go. Oh wow. Oh no. Okay, this is our crystal pixie flight number 2. All right. Let's try that again. Every time. I'm gonna try and guide this with my hands. No, come back. Oh. I think I'll place her in here and then we'll go. Oh, cool. Oh, she bounces. Sometimes. She sometimes bounces. Okay, so after that test, we've figured out that she bounces when she touches the floor. So maybe I can put my hand underneath and she might have a sensor or something which allows you to guide her. So I'm gonna try that again. Oh, awesome, all right. No, go back up. Oh. Go fly, come back. Ah. Bye. I have a feeling that the crystal flyer has some of the same issues as the old sky dancer did. I think it's time to pull her apart. Now, I'm not here to question the existence of pixie power, but I do have a feeling that there's something a bit more science-y going on that makes this toy work. Like lift. So there are quite a few other forces at play here as well that make this toy fly. Things like thrust, weight, and drag. We're not gonna get into that today. Maybe that's saved for another video. We're gonna have a look at lift. So in order for this toy to go upwards, it needs to generate a force known as lift. But how does it do that? So engineers call lift the differences in air pressure on a blade or rotor. On this toy, you can see that it is curved on the top and flat on the bottom. Why does this generate lift? Well, for lift to occur, the air pressure above the blade must be lower than the air pressure below the blade. Engineers realized that in order to make this happen whenever they wanted it, they need to make the top of the blade curved while the bottom of the blade is flat. And you can see that here. So if we have a look at our Pixie's pink rotors here, they're curved on the top and kind of flat on the bottom. So I say that these pink ones here are what is creating the lift. We also have the bottom ones here, which spin around, kind of like a rotor. It looks like her wings look very, very similar to helicopter rotors. And that is because it works exactly the same as helicopter rotors. The forces of lift, drag, thrust, and weight all help this toy fly the same as it does in a helicopter. There's actually a really good YouTube video explaining this in a little bit more detail, and we're gonna chuck the link in the description for you to watch after if you want to know a bit more about that. All right, enough talking about this toy and failing at flying it. I think it's time we tear this toy down. I'm gonna need a screwdriver. If you're gonna be pulling this toy apart, basically don't. It's really, really dangerous for toys that fly like this. Also, if you recently got a toy from someone as a gift, don't pull it apart because you might break it. Disclaimer over. So I couldn't get all of these screws out, but I think they don't need to come out because I don't think they're really holding much. Ah, okay, so let's just pull this out. There we go. That is so creepy. This is like the stuff of nightmares. Okay, we'll put her torso over here and have a look at this. So, got this pink sticky out bit here, which my guess is maybe it could be to sort of balance her. They kind of go up and down. Might take this bit off. How do the wings come off? I'm just gonna snap her wings off. Ooh. I wonder if she still flies like this. Headless and bottom wingless. I wonder what would happen if we turned her on now. This is where we really need a disclaimer. this could potentially be the very, very first ever Crystal Flyer headless flight. I'm just really interested to see if she still flies without all of her other wings. Are we ready? Are you ready? Awesome. Okay, turn her on. Interesting. Doesn't look like she flies. Okay, so now she will not turn off. There's literally no way to turn her off now. Don't try this at home. So, after all that, I just wonder why she didn't stop. It must have something to do with either any of the two things that we pulled off. So we pulled off her head and her body, and then there doesn't seem to be any major electronics in there, but this could provide some kind of structural integrity to the thing. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to put her wings back on and let's see if this time she stops. Now we're going to attempt headless flight with wings and see if that changes. I'm a bit scared of it now. Okay. Hey! Ah, okay, so I think I've just worked out what the purpose of the head is. So the head, I have to shout at you now because she's not gonna be quiet. I think the head actually pushes down and I notice there's a little button. So usually I think if she's supposed to hit the roof, that would maybe stop the motor or whatever's making her fly and make her come back down. But there's nothing forcing the head down. So, ooh, all right. Thankfully she just flew into a wall. So she just kind of got stuck on the roof and I think I've worked out why. So this kind of body bit attaches onto this pink thing here, which actually is like a button. And I think that actually would kill the motor. So she would actually fly back down. So she doesn't just continue flying into the air. Luckily we weren't outside, otherwise she would have just flown forever, which is pretty dangerous. It's why these toys, you probably shouldn't be pulling apart and you have to do it indoors. Are we happy with that? I think we can tear this down even further. All right, off with their wings again. Ooh. Ah, okay. I can see the things inside here, but I'm not entirely sure how to put. All right, I think I need to unscrew her legs first. All right. Wow. So there's a whole bunch of different technology inside our Crystal Flyer. This here sort of looks a lot like what you would get on a remote control or a TV. I think that's an infrared sensor, and this potentially is telling it where it is and whether it's too close to your hand. I don't know that for sure though. I'm going to do a little bit more research into it after this. But yeah, we've got our PowerPoint here. I have no idea what this is. It kind of looks like it maybe, it just looks like almost like an exhaust fan or something. We've got our LED here, so that's the light that turns on, and then we have her switch here, which I'm definitely not going to turn on. The motor, it's a tiny little motor there, which is creating the spin, and then her battery is just nestled inside. So there's this kind of rod which sticks through the middle and attaches to her legs as well. So these two parts move kind of together at the same time. Pretty cool. It's amazing how these have actually progressed over the years. It's definitely a lot more complex than the Sky Dancer I grew up with. So much electronics in here, and I found it particularly interesting that all of that power is coming from this very, very tiny little motor here. It's definitely helped by the shape of the wings, which are creating lift. I hope you enjoyed today's teardown. It was so much fun. Make sure you like, subscribe, add a comment in the comment section. We would love to hear your thoughts on the episode. Until next time, bye. I hated fairies as a kid.